I think yesterday's occurrence was pretty rare for all parties involved.
This is what 3,500 rental cars on fire looks like. Tonight, fire officials are working to figure out what started this massive fire at Southwest Florida International Airport. The big fire is your big story this evening. Good evening and thanks for watching ABC 7 tonight. I'm Simone Cucurullo. ABC 7's Megan Miller talked to the Florida Forest Service tree about how they're still working to keep that fire from flaring back up.
Firefighters have been here all day putting out hot spots. Among thousands of cars parked here, the flames got to about half of them, damaging or destroying around 3,500 cars. The fire also spread to the woods behind this overflow lot. You can see lots of charred trees. Florida Forest Service says the fire is 100% contained, but that doesn't mean it's completely out. As the sun came up, Florida Forest Service crews got their first look at the aftermath.
The charred trees and nastiness.
FFS supervisor Ryan Mason is talking about what he saw in the woods behind a lot full of burned out rental cars.
I think yesterday's occurrence was pretty rare for all parties involved.
After every area fire department worked hard into the night, FFS stayed to monitor it. They say they have the fire contained, but they are still working to control it.
At this point, we're just dealing with hot spots. It's hard to say that nothing will reflame.
The flames so high you could see them in other counties.
I can see it all the way from my house, about 20 minutes away.
Up closer, the sounds of tires and plastic exploding.
All the cars blowing up like pom, pom, pom.
Some were on the way to pick up family members.
I'm thankful that it's not a plane crash.
Anthony Sierra watched from the runway with no answers and his phone on airplane mode.
Seeing this right before takeoff was extremely terrifying. So much black smoke, and I thought maybe this could be like a plane. Did something happen? Like, could a plane have gone down?
The cause of the fire is still under investigation, but FFS says no one should have been burning here.
Right now we have restrictions put in place due to the time of year we're in and the weather. To my knowledge, we were not authorizing any acreage burns yesterday.
The Port Authority says the state fire marshal is now in charge of this investigation. If we get any new information confirmed, we'll bring you those updates both on air and online. I'm at RSW tonight, Megan Miller, ABC 7.
All right, Megan.